Good afternoon, my name is Eloísa Riva. On behalf of the Grupo de Estudio Latinoamericano de Mieloma Multiple, I thank the IMF for this invitation to present the results of this Latin American study on infections in myeloma. Infections are a significant cause of morbidity and mortality in patients with myeloma. A combination of impaired cellular and humoral immunity added to a particular demographic features like age, frailty, and comorbidities in these patients explain the increased susceptibility to infections. To date, data on the infectious complications in myeloma patients treated in Latin America are lacking. Therefore, we aim to prospectively study the epidemiology of infections and risk factors associated to their development. The primary outcome was to describe the epidemiology and risk factors for infections in newly diagnosed multiple myeloma patients. Primary outcomes were to describe the number of infectious events that require hospitalization for more than 24 hours within the first 6 months from diagnosis. Secondary outcomes were to describe the mortality rate at 6 months and to identify the cause of mortality. This prospective cohort study was developed in 6 Latin American countries between June 2019 and May 2020. Participating countries were Uruguay, Argentina, Chile, Panama, Cuba, and Venezuela. Inclusion criteria were active disease receiving therapy and a follow-up of 6 months from the time of diagnosis. Patients with other plasma cell disorders or HIV positive patients were excluded. Infectious events were defined as infections that require admissions for at least 24 hours. We classified infectious event as clinically defined when the infectious agent was not identified, or microbiologically defined when the agent was identified from blood cultures or other body sources. Early death was defined as death within the first 3 months from myeloma diagnosis, and the cause of death was classified as infectious or non-infectious. 248 patients were included in the study. The majority were male, IgG, due to salmon stage 3, and ISS 2 or 3. 50% had low albumin, and around 2/3 had immune paresis. 77% received antiviral prophylaxis, and 50% received trimetoprim sulfamethoxazole. Vaccination against Haemophilus influenza was 28%, and vaccination against Streptococcus pneumoniae were received by 18% of the patients. 89 patients, which means almost 1/3 of the total, had 113 infectious events. The majority of the events, 2/3 of the events, occurred within the first 3 months from diagnosis. 36% of patients had infectious complications in the first 6 months from diagnosis, and 23% of them had more than one infectious event. 2/3 of the patients of the infections occur in the first 3 months from diagnosis, and particularly during the first month. Patients with infections had more frequently due to salmon stage 3, ISS 3, anemia, renal impairment, and low albumin. And the frequency of infections according to therapy was 60% of patients receiving immunomodulatory agents, 33% of patients receiving proteasome inhibitors, and 24% of patients receiving a combination of IMiDs and proteasome inhibitors. The most common site of infections were respiratory and urinary tract. The infectious agent was identified in 57% of cases. Gram-negative bacteria prevailed, particularly Escherichia coli and Klebsiella pneumoniae. Viral infections were infrequent and no cases of fungal infections were described. In the multivariate analysis, a history of diabetes, creatinine above 2, serum albumin lower than 3.5, no use of antibacterial prophylaxis and treatment with immunomodulatory drugs were independent factors associated to bacterial infections. At 6 months, 21 patients had died, and almost 50% of them had died due to infectious complications. Overall, 18% of the patients of the infectious events resulted in admission to the intensive care unit. So in conclusion, we identified infections, largely bacterial, as a substantial cause of hospital admission and early death in newly diagnosed myeloma patients. Using this data, a risk-adapted approach has been recommended at the participating centers to reduce infectious complications. I would like to thank the colleagues contributing with this study and the Grupo Latinoamericano de Mieloma Múltiple. Thank you.